Welcome to Limor TV, the place to be to learn about money and get inspired to take small steps to improve your finances. While I'm not a financial planner, I'll show you what I've learned. In this episode, I'll be explaining nominal interest rate and effective interest rates. Come on, this will be fascinating. And effective interest rates. Let's decode this jargon. Back to basics. When you borrow money, whether it's on a credit card, a line of credit, a mortgage, either way, you're given an interest rate. The interest rate is the proportion of the amount loaned, which the lender charges the borrower. They aren't going to give you the money for free. This amount is expressed as a percentage. So basically, you have to pay a percent of what you borrow as interest. Being aware of the percentage is a good way to compare the costs of borrowing money from different banks. For example, if one credit card charges you 19.99% interest rate and another one charges you 12.99% interest rate, then it's easy to see that the cost of borrowing money will be more expensive on the credit card with 19.99% interest rate. Hope you're with me so far. Now, the amount of interest that a bank or a credit card provider gives you is called APR, which is the annualized percentage rate, or also known as the nominal interest rate. This is the periodic interest multiplied by the number of periods within a year. But what that really means is the amount of interest that you have to pay in a year if the interest is only compounded or calculated once a year. Hold on a second, let me recap. Nominal interest rate is also APR, and the amount of interest that you would pay over a year if interest was only compounded one time in a year. These are the rates you'll see when you see advertising commercials and you go into the bank. For example, you may see credit card with 21% interest rate, line of credit with 6% interest rate. What you're being shown is the nominal rate. So off you go, signing up with all of these great rates, but what most of us don't realize is that on these products, interest rates aren't compounded just one time a year. In fact, for most credit card, interest rates are actually compounded or recalculated every single day. The amount of interest you pay is based on the frequency of compounding. This is called the effective interest rate. So let's take a look at this together. If you think that you're paying 10% interest on a credit card, which is typically compounding daily, you're actually paying 10.52% just because of the fact that it's compounding daily. If you think that you're paying 20% interest on a credit card, again, which typically compounds daily, you're actually paying 22.13%. While the little bit of extra percent doesn't seem to make that much of a difference, just start to think about the impact it has if you owe a lot of money. By the way, this chart is in the downloadable, so you can look at it more closely on your own afterwards. Let's say that you owe $20,000 with 20% APR. Remember, we learned that that's the same as the nominal interest rate. You would pay $4,000 in interest a year. But if you owed the same $20,000 on a credit card that compounded daily, your effective interest rate would be 22.13%, which would mean that you would have to pay $4,426. That's an extra $426 to pay in interest. This is why you can have the same interest rate on different products and be charged different amounts. If you have outstanding debt on a credit card, you may want to consider transferring it to a line of credit or another credit product that has a lower interest rate and that perhaps compounds less frequently. That brings me to today's tweetable. Don't be fooled by advertisers' numbers. Know your effective rate. Here is my challenge to you. I want you to take a look at all of the outstanding money you owe on credit products. That could be credit cards, lines of credits, mortgages, etc. And I want you to figure out how often the interest compounds for each of these. Here's a hint. Take a look at the fine print on your next monthly statement, call your bank, or just Google the details of the specific product that you have. Don't forget to access the free downloadable below at limor.money to help you track the compounding frequency of your accounts. Does it surprise you to know that the interest rates aren't really what they seem? Leave a comment below letting me know what you think about effective interest rates. Did you like this video? Did you learn something? Subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you want even more tips and tricks to make your financial journey fun and exciting, come on over to limor.money and sign up for email updates. Remember, I'm not here to change who you are or how you live your life. I just have strategies to make you even more financially fabulous. Feel proud that you're learning and taking small steps to improve your finances. It will give you more confidence and peace of mind. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you next time on Limor TV.